The NTC sensor connected to Arduino, and Arduino will send data to computer through COM port. Here is Arduino code. This command will print the temperature result into COM port. Now we can read the temperature by communication window here. Now the result is about 30 degrees. Next, I will show you how to show the result by Visual Studio. Here is my project already finished. Now I will try to run it to see how it works. Here, the temperature here. Okay, let's see how the project is built. I will make new project here. First, we will choose typing Windows Phone application, and now type the name here. It is, for example, Arduino temperature. Okay, here is a form for. Of Visual Studio. Now if we first run it, now here the form has nothing anyway. It run has with no error. It's good. Now we will need the label. This label, you can see here, this label has a name, is label. We will need another label. Label number two. Label number two is for degree C here, and we will change the size. I will double the size. Okay, and we also need double size here. Now we will take out the serial port from here, and this is serial port 1. Name is serial port 1, and port name is a port COM7. In my project, is this COM port is COM port 7 here. You can see here the COM port number 7. Okay, so the problem is how to show the result in COM port to label 1. When this form is loaded, we need to open the serial port 1. Okay, click here, double click here, then enter serial port 1, open. We will open the port. When you open, when this form is loaded, this COM port will be open, and when this form is closed, we need to close the COM port. If we don't do that, the error will happen. Here is the code. When the form is closed, the code will complement here. So we will write down here is serial port 1 close. Okay, so let's see the code. Okay, that's good. It can run without any error. When data received to serial port, it will have an event. So we will use the event when serial port receive data. We will save data to some serial, some variable. So here we click to event, and here data received. We double click here. This is event when serial port receive data. So we will save data to variable. So we will make the global variable here. String variable, my string. Okay, and then we will save data my string to serial port 1 read line. Okay, so this code means that when serial port 1 receive data, we will save the data from serial port 1 to my string variable, and then we will show result my string to label 1. Okay, my string label, sorry, label 1 text. Okay, let's see the code. Unfortunately, the code has some error here. Actually, maybe label 1 cannot show data in this code. So we choose another solution, is use a timer here. Timer when it take the label 1, we change value. Okay, we choose the event here and double click here. Now when the timer tick, we will change value of label 1 text and string. That's okay. Run it. Right? Nothing changed. I forget to open the timer. So to open the timer, we will open it same with the serial port. Timer 1 open started, sorry. And then when we close this form, we need to close also stop the timer here. Timer 1 stop. Okay, now let's see the code. Oh great, now it's run up. Okay, we turn off, nothing happened. Okay, that's good.